Well, hello there, bitches and bros. It is Blame Truth, and I am bringing you a nasty little game with the Ballista. I go 60-5. I poop on kids' chest. I give them a Boston pancake. Ah! If you're curious as to what a Boston pancake is, I would advise against Googling it. Anyway, this is a game in progress because I got to shorten them somehow because, you know, a kill confirmed game on carrier is not going to end with all 100 tags being collected. It just doesn't happen. Anyway, I made a new channel, and I want to bring this to you guys' attention that may have missed the video yesterday due to YouTube shenanigans or not being on yesterday. Happy Thanksgiving, by the way, real quick. I want to get that out there. Anyway, yeah, I made a video yesterday talking about my new channel I made called The Whacking Dead, where I whack shit with zombie weapons, and there's lots of blood and tits and beards and flannel and blades and blunt weaponry. It's kind of like Skyrim mixed with zombies, mixed with stuff like that. It's really cool. If you want to check that out, you can click the annotation on the screen right now or click the link below in the video description. I really would like you to check it out because I spent a lot of time on it, and it's got the people that watched it loved it. So if it sounds interesting, check it out, subscribe, and I will be bringing more videos to that channel, as well as my own channel here, because this channel is great. I fast-forwarded that little part because I was just waiting for my stealth chopper to destroy them so I could get my epic warthog. It's great. But anyway, let's talk about the Ballista, and let's talk about my class setup. I got the Danger Close Wild Card, two bouncing Bettys, although I don't really use Bettys that much on this map. I think I only get like one or two kills with them this entire game. But I got that. I got the Ballista with the ballistic CPU BPD BVDs. I don't know. I forget what the abbreviation, you know, initials are, whatever. But something like that. You can find my class that I use. I screenshot it for you and I put it in the video description because I'm a cool guy like that. But I got hardline, toughness, and awareness on. Awareness does help a little with the footstep issue on Black Ops 2, where everyone runs around with pillows on their feet. I guess that's all the rage in the future. They run around with pillows and little, you know, nighttime fuzzy bear slippers on. I don't know. I don't know what the deal with that is, but after this first little flurry of mainly, I think I mainly get scar kills in the beginning. I got a few ballista kills at the start that you didn't see because I was like 3-2 before I cut the game or whatever to this particular part because it's exciting. But, yeah, the ballista, it's an interesting little weapon. It's an interesting little weapon. It has a few advantages and a few disadvantages over the other snipers. The first advantage is that it scopes in faster than the other ones, so it's kind of got like quick draw built in a way. It scopes in faster, and it has a unique attachment that is unlocked last called the Iron Sight attachment. Now, if you ever played World at War or Call of Duty 2, you know that scopeless snipers were a lot of fun to use. Well, maybe not in World at War, because everyone was running that there Juggernaut MP4 Dizzle. So, that's probably a bad example. But in Call of Duty 2, they were like borderline overpowered in multiplayer. But this is the only sniper that gets that attachment. So you're probably best off using it with the Iron Sight attachment. I haven't unlocked it yet because it's the last attachment. I'm trying to unlock it. But this is still a fine sniper. You got to hit from the chest up, though. This doesn't have a high rate of fire either. It's a bolt action, so you got to pick your shots and scope. Your advantages are basically you can scope in faster. I think you have reduced sway over the other ones. I think that one attachment that reduces sway is unique to this weapon. Don't quote me on that. I haven't used the snipers that much. I just started playing around with them today, and I just got this game today. So, but it's a nice little weapon. It's not bad. Just make sure you don't aim for the body or the arms. Go for the chest up only. And you'll be a winner. You will be the winner of the day. Anyway, though. Here's where I start getting some nasty shots and I start getting pretty surgical. I'm on the plane because I'm like freaking, you know, Top Gun up in here. And I see this guy over here And he's like ducking around, I guess because he sees me or something. The problem is, though, is that he's doing a very bad job of sneaking out with his RPG. And he gets his shit pushed in. But yeah, you'll see here, you know, chest up, one shot kill. Really fast scope in time. Well, not really fast, but faster than the other snipers. Ooh, look at that one shot kill. That is sexy. That's great. But really, I got the most kills, you know, earlier on in the game when I chained together some stealth choppers and some warthogs. It was some grand stuff, let me tell you. I love me a stealth chopper into a warthog. I think the warthog is my favorite higher-end score streak because I don't think it could be shot down. I've gotten lodestars before, and people have equipped I can't remember if it's cold-blooded or blind eye. I think it's cold-blooded. I think more people run cold-blooded generally than blind eye. I think more people are running ghost or flak jacket or whatever than blind eye. So the warthog is pretty darn good in that regard. I got a lot of nice kills with it this game. But yeah, it's one like 100 score lower than the Lodestar, so, and I don't think it can be shot down either, so it's pretty beast. Sometimes it kind of shits you though. You sometimes, like, Helen Keller's piloting it and it won't like kill anyone even though it's right under the jet, but if nothing else, it sounds cool. And Helen Keller, you know, although she's not a good driver, is an inspirational person. So, you know, if nothing else, the Warthog can be very inspirational towards your ambitions and stuff like that in life. But yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm rambling. No, I'm not high. People have been asking if I've been high lately. Nah, man, I'm high on life. I'm high on life, dog. Just cause I act all goofy, and I make goofy noises, and I go brrrr and stuff like that does not mean I'm on any kind of drug or I'm under the influence of anything that can mess with your brain. No, sometimes I'm just a cool guy. I got my, you know, my ballista, and I'm sniping like a cool guy, and it's great. But yeah, go give this sniper a try. Go unlock the iron sight attachment and let me know how it rolls. I know Hutch has been raving about it on Twitter. Every tweet from him is either the ballista's great or I love my wife or something like that. So he loves his ballista and he loves his wife very much. So you know, give it a try. Let me know how it is. I get a final little stealth chopper here to finish up the game. Unfortunately, I get pooped on in a very disgusting manner. But anywho, this is the final kill cam. Look at this shit. Boom! Boosh! Get sniped, biatch. And final score is 60-5. Man. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you'd like to see a particular weapon used in my videos going forward, let me know. I just prestiged for the second time. I don't usually prestige, but Treyarch kind of forces you to in this game. Anyway, though, if you enjoyed the video, give it a like, rating, subscribe for more. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.